Guys, recall there was the Charlottesville, Virginia march, and that led to, that was a protest, and then there were counter protesters, and then a car rammed into a group of counter protesters, which led to the death of one woman and 19 people being injured. Now, there has been a concerted effort to out these people marching because they didn't wear hoods. The KKK, the Ku Klux Klan, they wore hoods for a reason. They want to keep their job. They don't want to be known, because if they do, there are going to be a lot of repercussions. So I had done like a little thread on Twitter at the time of the people who had gotten fired for being taking part in this or being a Nazi. So who lost their job, and there's also a petition for a school to expel this one guy. I don't remember his name. But now there is this 21-year-old Charlottesville marcher who is now whining about his outing by an anti-fascist group. He says, quote, "My life is over." Well, guess what, buddy? You should have thought about that before you did it. But I don't want his life to be over necessarily. But let's get into this. So Ross Story says, a 21-year-old Honeoye Falls NY man, I don't know how to say that, NY man was outed as a white supremacist after photos of him marching in Charlottesville, Virginia circulated online. According to the Livingston County News, Jerrod Kuhn was filmed on Friday and Saturday last week by a BBC documentary crew as he carried a torch of the on the University of Virginia campus and chanted Nazi slogans and marched with the KKK and neo-Nazis the following day. They had some really crazy chants. They had, they had fuck you faggots. They had blood and soil, the Nazi chant. They had Jew will not replace us. They had white lives matter. Fucking crazy. So they say Rochester, a New York-based group called Eastside Antifascists, took still images of Kuhn and distributed 250 flyers bearing his photo throughout the Falls area with the slogan, quote, "No Nazis in our neighborhood." The flyers explain that Kuhn is a participant and prolific poster at a neo-Nazi website, The Daily Stormer, an avowedly neo-Nazi website around which local groups have been organizing to promote anti-Semitism, white supremacy, and violence against LGBTQ communities. So, The Daily Stormer, I guess he is a poster over there at The Daily Stormer. I don't know if he still is. The Daily Stormer, if you don't know, is like a legitimate racist douchebag website, if I've ever seen one in my life. So they're superbly anti-Semitic as well. They're a fringe far-right, basically. And if you don't know, Faith Goldie from the Rebel Media actually got fired for doing a podcast with them. But these guys are really crazy. When Heather Heyer, who was the marcher who died, the counter-protester, they posted an article saying, childless old slut or something like that. And so GoDaddy actually told them, hey, you broke our terms of service, so we are no longer going to host your website. And then Google picked them up, and then Google dropped them, and now I think there's some Russian registry or something like that. But this guy, he says he's not racist, but he traveled nearly 500 miles to protest the removal of the Confederate statue. Go fuck yourself, dude. What's up, guys? It's Sawhill here. You guys are watching The Progressive Voice. Make sure you guys click subscribe down below. We're fighting Donald Trump tooth and nail, and we need your help.